Well, hello there. Welcome in. Today I'm sharing a whole bunch of really cool things that I found on Amazon. All of them are very different. They're all interesting and some of them are quite surprising, and I can't wait to share all of them with you. If you're new to my channel, welcome in. I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. I hope you'll consider subscribing while you're here and make sure you click that notification bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you're interested in more makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman stuff, by prettyover50.com. There's a lot more great information just waiting for you there. Today I'm sharing a whole bunch of very cool items that I found on Amazon. There's some real surprises in here, and as always, everything that I mentioned today will be listed and linked below. And they'll also be over on the blog, so super easy for you to find. And with that, let's hop into the cool Amazon finds. The first thing I want to talk about is this amazing laundry soap from a company called Tyler. Oh, I know laundry soap cannot be thrilling, but this one actually is. I found this really unique laundry soap, and I'll tell you why I love it so much. It has a scent that is divine, and it lasts on what gets washed in this laundry soap. I love to do my towels and sheets in this laundry soap because the scent will stay for weeks after I've washed them, and the scent is so lovely. I no longer use any towels without smelling them first because it's so wonderful. Tyler actually makes candles, scented candles for your home, and they branched into this laundry soap, and it's just the coolest soap. I'll tell you how I do it. I'll use almost a full amount of my regular laundry soap, and then I'll just use 1 or 2 tablespoons of this in the wash load, and that will scent the whole load of clothes. I absolutely love my towels now because they always smell so good. Then I just throw the whole load in the dryer with dryer sheets and I'm good to go. This bottle of laundry soap is a little bit expensive for this size of laundry soap, but I'll tell you, I only use really 1 or 2 tablespoons for every load, and for me it is so worth it. It just makes the towels and sheets so much more delightful. I originally tried the Tyler in a little gift set. You get 3 of these smaller little laundry soaps and I think a couple of candles in the little set, and I'm pretty sure the price is under $30 for the little trial set. I went through all 3 of these, there's 3 different scents, and just so enjoyed it that I went ahead and bought the bigger bottle of the Tyler. So if you love things that smell wonderful and a scent that lasts for a long time, I can tell you this Tyler is really a hit with me. I recently lightened my hair, and my hair turns really yellow when I lighten it very, very easily. It comes from the pollutants in the air, things in the water. Anyway, my hair will turn yellow really, really quickly, even when I've lightened it quite a bit. I always need to use a purple shampoo, and I finally found one that really does a great job. This is from a company called Malibu, and it's Malibu Blondes. This is the first shampoo that I could say really keeps the yellow out of my hair, and I'm able to use this in between going to my hairdresser every 6 or 8 weeks and not have my hair turn a really brassy shade of yellow. If you struggle with your hair turning color in between going to the stylist, or if you have gray hair that you want to keep the yellow out of, I can tell you, I've probably tried 4 or 5 different purple shampoos on my hair, and this one is the one that really, really works. So Malibu Blonde, you can find this right on Amazon. If you have trouble with your hair turning a little bit of the yellow brassy tones, this might be the solution for you. So many of us are now working out at home because either our gyms are closed or we don't want to go there anyway. Working out at home has become a really big thing. If you have tried to buy dumbbell weights online to work out at home, you probably have found that you can't buy them anywhere. Honestly, everyone is sold out. I actually ordered a set of dumbbells from Amazon, I think in the middle of December. They still haven't come yet, and it's the middle of February. They keep saying the delivery is delayed. I don't know. Anyway, finding weights to work out at home is really tough right now, but you can find kettlebells. And to be honest with you, I prefer kettlebells over dumbbell weights. There are so many different exercises that are really going to work out many parts of your body with the kettlebells. I find them much more efficient and much more fun to work out with than dumbbells. There's about 1,000,001 kettlebell workouts here on YouTube, and often I'll just turn on a workout and follow along. I ended up buying two sizes of kettlebells. This one is 15 pounds and this one is 20 pounds. So I'll go back and forth and use either the 15 pound or the 20 pound depending on what exercise I'm doing. So if you're interested in working out at home and you want to add some weights to your routine, you might want to consider kettlebells. I actually really, really love them. There are so many cool exercises that are so effective and work multiple parts of the body that I find it to be a really, really great way to get a good workout in a short amount of time. Kettlebell is truly one of my favorite recent purchases from Amazon. This next purchase I've actually talked about before on my channel. I love this sweetener. I don't actually eat sugar anymore, much to my disappointment, but I did give up sugar. Every now and then I'll have a little bit of sugar, but in general, I don't include sugar in my diet. However, I do like sweet things. I found this sweet leaf organic stevia on Amazon. This is the best sweetener I found. It really does taste like sugar, and it doesn't have that nasty aftertaste that you can often get with a sugar substitute. I buy this big box. There's 70 packets in here, and you can see I just rip the lid off and I keep it in my cupboard, and it comes in these little individual packets. They're not expensive, they're really handy, and it really does satisfy my sweet craving when I want to sweeten my tea or my coffee, or I've even used this in cooking. So I really love the Sweet Leaf brand of stevia. It's the best tasting one I've found. Okay, you guys, this next one is kind of goofy, but if you own one, you'll be so glad that you did because they come in so handy. This is a ring sizer. As I've shared in the past, I'm a jewelry junkie. That's kind of my weakness, that and lipstick. I've been buying a lot of jewelry online recently, so I can't try the rings on. Sometimes I'll want to fit rings for different fingers than my ring finger. For instance, I recently bought a thumb ring and I had no idea what size my thumb was. So I went ahead and purchased a ring sizer. This thing has been so stinking handy. I'm able to size any finger now. So if I want to get a ring for my pinky or my forefinger or any of my other fingers, I can very, very easily find out what size I am, and I don't have to go back and forth sending back rings that don't fit. These ring sizers are so inexpensive, and I'll tell you, once you own one, you could have it for the rest of your life. They don't wear out, and they really are very, very handy. I know at times when I'll add a few pounds or lose a few pounds that that will impact my ring size, so I'm really glad that I've got this ring sizer. If you don't have one, you might want to think about getting one, particularly if you're a jewelry lover like I am. The next thing I want to show you is something that I've recently added to my guest bathroom, and it is this little ladder. You might have seen these little ladders on decorating channels being used for blankets. Well, I had this area in my guest bathroom right next to the mirror that was kind of recessed, and I wanted to put something there, but I wasn't sure what would really fit. So I had this little hand towel basket, and one of the things that was a problem for me in this guest bathroom is that the shower is here, but the towel rack is all the way over here. So there was really no way to get out of the shower and have a towel handy for when you wanted to dry off. That's where the idea of putting one of these racks right next to the shower came to me. I absolutely love the way it fits in here, and let me show you another cool thing that I've done. I added a little S-hook right here at the top, and now it's a place to hang your towel when you get into the tub or the shower, and when you're done, you just flip open that little shower curtain and your towel is waiting for you right there. So this little rack I found on Amazon, it really wasn't that expensive for what it is. It's all metal, there's three rungs, and I think it just looks terrific in my bathroom. This next item is sort of a hot travel tip. Some of you might know that I lived in Florence for a couple of months a few years back. While I was there, I got hooked on this Lavazza coffee, and this is what I would have in my little apartment every morning before I started my day. I got it at the little local grocery store right down the street from my place, and I fell in love with this coffee. I would brew it every morning and then add hot milk to it. It was so good. When I got home, I really missed having this as my morning coffee, and I was able to find it on Amazon, and it's not expensive. I believe I get a 4-pack of these for under $20, or right around $20. This coffee is so delicious, but I'll tell you what, if you don't like strong coffee, you won't like this. This is strong coffee. It's really rich, really flavorful, and so smooth. That's one thing I really noticed about the coffee when I was in Italy. It's a lot smoother. It doesn't have that bitterness that some coffee that we get here in the States does. So super smooth, super rich, super yummy coffee. You can find this right on Amazon, and you can feel a little bit like you're visiting Italy. This next find I've mentioned before, but I want to mention it again because it's become such a handy part of my life. This is a little neck light, and you can see I'll turn it on right here. I was looking for something to use in the evening. I crochet in the evening quite often, and I don't like to have all the bright lights on in my living room in the evening. I like it a little bit more muted with the fireplace on. I wanted some type of reading light that I could see my crochet work with, but I didn't want to light up the whole room. I found these neck lights on Amazon. Apparently, this is the new style for reading lights, and it's actually really a good one. I found that this style of light is a lot more comfortable and a lot easier to use than standard reading lights. It simply just goes right around your neck, and it has adjustable lights here so that you can move them around any direction that you need that light. In addition, there's lights on both ends, and they have three different settings: dim, medium, and bright. So I can turn on the setting that I want, and I don't even have to turn both on. They're independently operated. At first, when I saw this, I thought, oh, I don't know if that's going to be heavy on my neck and feel uncomfortable. Well, the answer is it absolutely doesn't feel uncomfortable. I actually forget that it's even there. I just place it around my neck, and I'm able to work with anything, whether I'm writing or crocheting or doing anything that I want a little bit of focused light with. This really, really works well. I'm so glad that someone came up with this new style. As far as recharging, it charges with a USB cable. I simply plug it into my computer, and this charges in just about 20 minutes, and I have a full charge. It's going to last me a long time. If you're in the market for a reading light and you haven't tried this new style yet, I can tell you it's really good, and I love using it. This next one is a little surprising, but I think everyone needs one. This is a camping light. I've actually owned this style of camping light for quite some time. I recently bought a set of two for inside my home. And you want to know why? Because if the power goes out, I've got two great lights that will really light up a room. They're so stinking handy. I use these in my tent when I used to camp before, and it's so bright. I'm not going to turn it on now because it would be way too bright. I keep these right off of my kitchen, and they're waiting for the time that the power goes out and I need to light things up. I find these so much handier than a flashlight because I can just set it on the counter. I've got plenty of light, and if I want to move it, I just grab it and take it with me. They're super light. You can see they're really small compared to the size of my hand, but I'll tell you what, these are so bright, and often I'll just open it up part of the way in order not to blast the whole room. But if you want a whole lot of light, you simply pull it all the way up. These are not expensive, they're battery powered. They're wonderful to take camping, but what I really love it for is backup lighting in case I lose power. So a cool little gadget from Amazon. I want to finish up with a little set that I've talked about before, but I wanted to mention it again. This is a little spa headband set, and I love this set. I've had them about probably 3 months now, and it's one of those things where I like them better now even than when I first got them. They're just really growing on me. They come in a 3-pack, and this is the colorway I got: gray, white, and black. And I'll show you why I like them so much. First of all, they're super affordable. Second, they're nice and thick, so it really does hold my hair back and it feels really snug on my head. They have a little bit of give to them, but not too much. And then there's a Velcro opening right here, so you can put it on loosely or tightly, however best fits your head. They wash up great in the washing machine, and I just put them right back in my bathroom cupboard and they're good to go. I can use one of these, gosh, for probably a week or more before I feel like I need to wash it. They've washed up and they look like brand new. If you're interested in keeping your hair out of your face while you're washing your face or putting on your skincare, I can tell you these have really, really worked for me. Well, those are my cool finds from Amazon. I'm so glad you joined me. I hope you found it fun, useful, and helpful. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you're interested in more makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman, stop by prettyover50.com. There's a lot more great information just waiting for you there. You guys know how much it means to me when you take a few minutes out of your day to spend it with me. I appreciate that, and I appreciate you. Again, I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. Make it a great day, wear your sunscreen and all. See you in the next video. Bye now.